time to time, I peruse my channel and I see that there's still growth. And I know I joke about it a bit at times, but I am truly grateful for all of you and the additional traffic that spares a few minutes to hear a brutally outspoken but humble and sincere individual go to town with expletives and offer his thoughts on things. So I had a bit of an epiphany, you can say, and I figured, maybe this is a good time to offer a bit more transparency. And no, not along the lines of a face reveal or anything like that, but on a particular subject, a sensitive subject that I actually got wind of fairly recently in a few comments and even on Twitter. So guys, brace yourselves because I'm about to give my thoughts on politics. Dun, dun, dun. No, not really. And it's not just because of my channel that I never worry about what people think when it comes to my thoughts on anything. But I do want to take a more human-like approach, if you will, when it comes to certain things. Now, I already know how politics goes. The healthiest thing you can do is not talk about politics. Well, it's a good thing that I love a challenge. So this may be a bit underwhelming or overbearing for some of you, but this is just how I feel. Now, I'm going to start with saying that I am not the most versed in any way, shape, or form when it comes to the ins and outs of politics. But what I will say, and I did allude to this in my previous video, yeah, literally, the video before this one, and that is that I feel that picking sides when it comes to politics, and many things for that matter, is just the act of an uninformed and distracted child. It takes away from the big picture, and that is, aside from politics, what truly changes for the better in this country. Oh, and before I go any further, I apologize for a lack of screens and content for you to look at as I have this discussion. If only I had one of those fancy gameplay videos for you guys to watch. But anyway, with all of that said, ladies and gents, it's easy to see what side I lean towards. And that, of course, as with anything else in my life, I lean towards the side that consists of me, myself, and I. Yeah, I know that's a pretty lame cop-out, and it doesn't say much, but think about this. Regardless of either side, they both have their strengths and weaknesses, but they're both also absolutely fucked up in so many ways. And this can be attributed to a lot of things, but most importantly, I see both sides as nothing more than a schoolyard debacle that really does nothing for the country ultimately. It's just a bunch of back and forth, infantile noise of clashing ideals, and no one ultimately putting aside their stupid ass differences to accomplish anything on a grand scale. Again, the big picture. The Republicans can be credited as the conservatives, and from what I observed, ultimately with these guys, they prefer things to stay the same, and too much change is overbearing. I don't agree with a regressive mentality, because if anything, things need to always move forward, and it seems like every time something is proposed, it's always some kind of handout and easy way to them, instead of them popping their bubble and just trying something different than what they are used to. The Democrats, on the other hand, are coined as the liberals, and there's a lot of wokeness in this party, and they seem to be a bit reckless when it comes to proposals to make that very change I'm talking about. Like I said, I don't know the whole story, do correct me if I'm wrong here, but that tends to be the gist of both parties, and I guess that's why they clash. Like I said, different ideals, but this is one of the reasons why I don't lean towards either side, but at the same time, I can't remember the last time I voted for anyone. I mean, that's just my philosophy, flawed it may be, but the way I see it is that if you want my vote, you gotta give me a reason other than some schoolyard fucking background noise that at the end of the day achieves absolutely nothing. Like, where the fuck is my second stimulus check? They're still locking horns over shit like this. And oh look, once again, they have proven that they're not for the people, but for their ego and to flex whatever power they're handed. That's the grand reason why I have no problem with not voting. But by all means, do you. You clearly aren't me. It's not enough for them to be flawed, but they have to reassure me that, hey, you're really not thinking about the working class individual, are you? And yeah, I know, concerning voting, the sacrifices made for me to have that right have my undying respect, but the way I see it, I'd rather not waste it than to utilize it on this bag of political garbage. Another thing that I will mention, in my humble opinion, and that's probably the most biased take I will make in all of this, is that I think Trump is the most incompetent and unqualified president to ever exist yet in the history of this country. This is the apprentice guy whose track record consists of filing bankruptcy, and you think that he's gonna lead this country to the promised land? Not to shit on anyone's vote, and I think with things of late, really should put people on to what this man is really about, at least how he functions. I don't care too much about his personality, and that's neither here nor there. But when you have a personality where you function like an 8-year-old spoiled brat, anytime someone confronts you rather than fuck you with blind praise and accolades, to me that's not becoming of a president in any way, and that's just shitty character. Who does that sound like? And as far as the whole wall thing goes, I think that's just propaganda for votes. I mean, yeah, there is an immigration issue when it comes to the budget of this country. But if you think that a wall is supposed to solve all your problems and, again, bring this country into the promised land, well, it's easy to see that that wasn't going to be a simple task to achieve either. And by the way, did he ever get his wall? Because last time I checked, both of them are going to be pulling from the pockets of the working class, individual any fucking way. Simply put, I believe that Trump is nothing more than the all style and no substance vote. People love his personality. They love that he doesn't back down. They love that he's different. They may even love that he's a Republican. Either way, he hasn't convinced me any more than either side of the political spectrum. Now let's see what else. Another reason why politics are so skewed to me is the fact that the media plays a huge role in this as well. Let's not forget those guys. Remember, garbage journalism, because all these guys need is a story for clicks and the paycheck. Let's not act like they don't take advantage of that just to push whatever the fuck they want to push. And that's anything but the facts. And that leads to all kinds of misconceptions, like with Republicans and Democrats, and even Trump. So that's definitely something worth mentioning. Along with Robert Trump, Trump's younger brother, passing recently. Just putting that out there, I swear I'm a news channel at times. So simply put, it's just hard to get into politics, be a fan of it, and even have a discussion. But I think I did all right. There's too much pestilence in politics that pushes me away and makes me not want to be bothered with it in any way. And it's easy to see why this will never become a political channel. You're not going to see me wearing a stupid hat. You look outside and you see the country getting no better. Speaking of which, I think that's Trump's biggest mistake yet, the pandemic. No, I'm not blaming him per se. We can point fingers at China as well if that's the case. His failure to take this pandemic seriously. Like I said, I love to look at the big picture and things if that's not evident enough. As a working class individual, it's easy to see what really matters out there. That vote for me and I'll set you free bullshit is still alive and well. We can vote all day long. You can lean towards either side, but at the end of the day, what changes for the better? Fuck politics. I'm looking for my second stimulus check. People need money. And if politics has taught you anything, it's a constant that remains the same and probably will remain the same for the remainder of humanity. It's politics. Give me something or someone for the people. Other than that, I just shifted to this page just to give you guys one more thing to look at. To feel the dead air. Not bad, eh?